Zoxo, a cold-blooded killer. Netflix's latest thriller The Weekend Away, based on the novel of the same name by Sarah Alderson, stars Leighton Meester, Gossip Girl, as new mother Beth who is whisked away for a girl's vacation in Croatia by her best friend, newly divorced, Kate, played by Christina Wolfe, Batwoman.
2 weekends away. With best friends.
But when Beth wakes up with no memory of the night, discovers Kate is missing, she is sent on a wild chase to try and figure out what happened to her friend. As we get into the twists and turns of The Weekend Away and reveal exactly what happened to Kate, we're going to run into spoilers, so now is your warning to look away. The movie picks up with Beth arriving in Croatia, being dropped off outside a beautiful Airbnb by a handsome taxi driver named Zane, Zayed Bakri, who gives Beth his card in case she needs any more taxi rides. Kate, already there, reveals that she's using her ex-husband's credit card to pay for the holiday, before he realizes she's still on it, or she hits the limit. Beth apologizes for being such a bad friend, and gives Kate a gift of a necklace with black onyx beads which Kate puts on, only for a bead to fall off. As they get ready for their night out, Beth video calls her husband Rob, Luke Norris, Poldark, back in London with their new baby Aster, but when Kate comes into the frame, Rob acts coolly towards her.
Okay. Yeah, hi, I'm Beth. It's nice to meet you. Everything's cool.
Over dinner, Kate is about to tell Beth something, but they're interrupted by a waiter. Later, we see Kate in an argument on the phone with, Beth assumes, her ex-husband Jay. At Kate's urging, they're driven to a nightclub by Zane, who reveals he's Syrian, and Beth speaks to him in faltering Arabic, explaining she used to work for a relief organization. Zane and Beth clearly have a connection, but Kate is doing coke in the back of the taxi and is preoccupied with getting Beth excited for clubbing. In the club, Kate urges Beth to flirt and hook up with one of two hot men they've sat down with, but Beth hesitates. Kate, however, invites them back to the Airbnb. Flash forward to the next morning and Beth wakes up to find no sign of Kate, but a broken wine glass and blood on the floor. She calls Zane to drive her to the police, but the male detective Pavic, Amar Bukvi, dismisses her concern over Kate, claiming her friend probably went out clubbing again and ditched her. She bonds with Zane over her concern for Kate, and he helps her track down the guys from the club who turn out to be escorts Kate hired for Beth to sleep with.
Oh my god. She kept going on and on about how I needed to have some fun.
They trace the men down and Zane threatens one of them by dangling him over a wall. He reveals they stole Kate's bag and pawned it, but didn't kill her, and they go back for the bag and give it to Beth.
When was the last time you saw her?
She brings it to the police, but doesn't say that Zane helped her find the men. The other detective, a woman named Kavak, Iva Mihalik, has Beth go to the hospital for a checkup, and when she returns to her Airbnb she finds her creepy landlord packing Kate's things as checkout is passed, and he has new tenants arriving. When she reveals that there's still no sign of Kate, and she isn't leaving until she finds out what happened, he offers her a spare room he has in the ground floor of his home. She calls Kate's ex Jay, who reveals that he hasn't spoken to Kate in months, and all communication has to go through their lawyers, leading Beth to wonder who she was arguing with over dinner.
I have a clue and they're barely lifting a finger to find her.
Later that night, on her way to have dinner with Zane, Rob appears, having left their baby with the babysitter and flown to Croatia to help her. He's clearly unsettled by Zane's presence, but Zane takes no offense and leaves. The next day, Kate's body is discovered in the water, and the police decide to treat it as suspicious, a hunch eventually confirmed by the autopsy.
Oh my god.
On the way to the station, Beth asks Pavic to take her to the morgue to see her friend one last time, and while he leaves to give her some privacy, she holds Kate's phone over her face to unlock it. On her way out, she goes to the bathroom, where she sees frequent calls to someone labeled Handyman, and when she dials the number, it goes to Rob's voicemail. She scrolls through text messages to discover Kate and her husband, who's returned to London, were having an affair. In the interrogation room, Kavak reveals the autopsy confirmed Kate had ketamine and cocaine in her system, but that Beth's checkup also revealed ketamine, which Beth takes to confirm her suspicion she was drugged. Kavak asks one last time if there's anything Beth hasn't told them, but she says no, choosing to keep her husband and Kate's affair a secret. Pavic says they need her passport until they can check out her story, and he takes her back to the Airbnb. Later, she has lunch with Zane, in which they bond further. That evening, she angrily calls Rob to confront him, which he initially denies, before giving in and begging her to come home. She reveals she can't because the police think she had something to do with Kate's murder and that, if they find out about the affair, they'll have all the circumstantial evidence they need to charge her. She's called back to the station, where she's confronted once again by Kovac, who reveals that they know about the affair, and they also tell her that Zane has ties to the Albanian mob.
Why?
Beth's lawyer arrives and gives her a card saying to call her before saying or doing anything else. Beth returns to the Airbnb to discover Zane waiting for her, so she confronts him over the accusations of the police. He reveals that he helped remove shrapnel from the leg of the son of an Albanian mob boss who helped him escape Aleppo and set him up with a visa in Croatia, and Beth believes him. Lying in bed, Beth ruminates on how the police knew about the affair, and then she discovers a hidden camera in her mirror, so she begins to snoop, but her landlord interrupts her. While chatting, she sneaks the key off his ring, and when he is gone, she goes into his recording studio and discovers cameras in all the rooms where he's spying on the guests. The archival footage reveals that she was indeed drugged and passed out. Kate put her to bed before continuing to party with the two escorts, but while she went to shower, they stole her bag and ran off. She followed them in a taxi and later returned, dropped off by a black SUV. Distracted by the footage, Beth fails to notice the landlord returning until she hears the front door open. She surprises him by opening the studio door in his face, and then she runs for the front door, but can't unlock the bolt without a key, all the while accusing him of being a pervert.
No!
He begins to delete the videos via his phone, but a distraught Beth needs the video to prove her innocence, and they struggle over the device before he falls and hits his head. She grabs the keys off his presumed dead body, but he rouses, and she runs to find Zane, whom she texted earlier, and jumps in the cab. Zane takes her to the taxi depot, where they track down the driver who picked her up, and he reveals he took Kate to the police station. However, Beth's face is now all over the news in connection with Kate's death, and the dispatcher calls the police. When they arrive, Beth recognizes the license plate of the car that dropped Kate off the last time she was seen alive from the landlord's footage as belonging to Pavic. They hide from the police in an alley, where Beth tells Zane it was Pavic who killed Kate. Zane distracts the cops, telling her to run and call her lawyer. She's cornered by Pavic on a roof, and he threatens her when she reveals what she knows.
Killed her!
What?
However, Kovac shows up, and when Pavic turns, he slips on a stone and falls through the gap in the roof that leads to the stone courtyard below. Later at the station, Kovac reveals that they were able to find some footage remaining that confirms Beth's story, as well as revealing that Pavic was accused of assaulting sex workers during his time at Vice, and Beth is released. Back in London, Beth and Rob have divorced, and Zane is in London, we assume, based on his text message. Beth brings Aster to Rob for the weekend, and while she's there, he tries to get her to stay for tea, but she says no. Instead, she asks for her spare car key back, and he tells her to look in the bowl by the door or his jacket pocket, but when she reaches into the pocket, she finds one of the beads of Kate's necklace. Beth goes into the bathroom and calls Kovac, now believing it was Rob who killed Kate, but before she can say anything, Rob knocks on the door. She opens it and says she will stay for tea, but at the table she confronts him, and he reveals that he did fly to Croatia a day earlier to confront Kate and beg her not to reveal the affair. They fought and he hit her, she slipped and hit her head. He believed her to be dead, but Beth says the autopsy confirmed that she was alive when she fell in the water and he left her to drown. Rob begs her not to call the police, but Beth reveals that she has had Kovac on the line the whole time and Kovac has called the British police. They fight and Beth hits him in the throat and the groin, as Zane had instructed her previously. She grabs her baby and heads out as sirens blare, coming to arrest Rob.